I've got some company. What these guys are on. One of the riders wants to talk to me. I think he recognized me. Ooh, there's a lot of them there. Who are these people? Nice. They well equipped. Look like, wow, looks like a big tour. How you going?
Hey, I'm a huge fan.
Oh, thank you so much. Nice to meet you. What's your name? What's your name?
Britt.
Britt?
Britt.
Oh, oh, Britt.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Oh, thank you. How you going?
John.
Nice to meet you. Thank you. I need to give you my stickers then. Oh my God. Everyone who recognizes me gets a sticker.
How's my hair?
Oh, it's wonderful.
It's great.
It's actually pretty amazing you can spend so much time on a motorcycle and look so good.
That's right.
Better pod.
Are y'all ready?
We ready.
Say whiskey.
Sure. Nice to meet you. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much.
Good luck.
Enjoy your ride. Be safe. We have a beautiful weather, hey? Yeah. We were very lucky. A few days back, it was freezing. It was -5 Celsius in the park. This is so cool. I haven't been socializing with so many riders at the same time. See ya! For such a long time. This is like Big Bend is the place to be, definitely. He's home.
Awesome.
How are you?
Good. You?
Long time no see.
Yeah. It's like been forever.
Well, but listen, I'm going to the party. I was thinking maybe you want to come.
Where to?
You know the party, like there's some sort of event like down the road.
The alien invasion party, is that what they call it?
I'll have my hair.
How's my? Okay. I think your hair is ready, Joe. Okay, so I managed to convince Jay to come with me. The event is only 7 kilometers away. We have no booking for camping. Jay actually doesn't, his bike is ready. He hasn't unpacked it since the last trip, but he still doesn't know if he's gonna camp, but he's ready, just in case. So yeah, it would be just nice to ride together there and see what's going on, and hopefully they let us in because we have no booking. Here goes Jay. We'll hit some gravel. We'll be right back.
back on the pavement for a little bit. And we're back on the gravel. So this is pretty much, I think, gravel that goes all the way to the campground. Okay, campground. Ooh, closed. So we were very lucky. This is Rachel. Rachel's gonna guide us in because everything is booked out online. But we're pretty sure there will be space for us. Well, for me. Jay doesn't know if he's staying still. So we follow Rachel now, and she's gonna take us to the owner. So yeah, that's pretty much someone's private property. I mean, there's so much space, right? I'm sure there's a space for Chili and me. Hi! How you going?
This is Jeff.
So I found out there's something going on here, and it's apparently an epic event. I don't have a booking. Is there a chance you can squeeze me in?
Probably.
Oh, thank you so much. So this is my friend Jerry. He lives just in Terlingua. So he's just a company for
Anita and Leon.
For a day. But I would like to stay for tonight if that's okay.
Sure.
Thank you. How much is the camping?
It is, with the event and everything, it's $50.
Perfect. I've got cash.
Okay.
Should I pay now?
That would cover both of you for a campsite.
Oh, sweet. So you can make a choice if you want to stay or not.
Okay.
Sweet, that's perfect. Yeah. Do you want me to pay now?
Sure.
Okay.
While you're here.
Yeah.
Music. It's a burlesque show tonight.
20.
Thank you. And
5.
And then there'll be...
five.
And then tomorrow night at 7 o'clock, a band called the Stinky Wrinkles hits the stage. They're out of Austin. And then the traditional Red Elvises.
Cool.
Have you heard of
No, but I'm so excited about everything.
Oh, it's great. And then,
I literally found out by chance today. Yeah. I was going to the park, like someone told me, this is happening here. Like, okay, well, I'll go here.
It's a great party. It's kind of like, we call it our Burning Man of Terlingua.
Yeah.
You do whatever you want. You're on a private ranch. And
awesome.
You let loose and you're camping, so you're not driving. So
exactly.
As much as you want to.
Oh, thank you so much for letting me stay on this short notice.
Yeah.
All right. I think we're just going to go. You know what? Let's just go here. But this will be good, I think. Okay, Jay. How's that for a campground? So much shade. Lucky I have that amount of sunscreen with me.
Teletubby.
Teletubby. My
spike.
Okay, let's go with that. Right, so we arrived to our campground. Jay will not stay for tonight, but that's okay. It's nice that he came all the way with me. I actually thought this place is going to be packed, but a couple of hours later, it doesn't look like there's too many people. But I think the main event is tomorrow, so that's okay. So now it's time to set up my tent. All right, I think here where the tent's gonna go. 1, 2, 3. Jay, come into the frame. Yes, we're here. How's our hair? It's matching. Our hair is matching. Totally. Jay.
Yes.
This is a very special moment. I've been carrying this Polish pate since September. I flew in with my visa to Canada with this when I was getting my USA visa in Poland. So I bought a lot of them, and I kept this one, like very last one, on it for the very special occasion when I'll be like so desperate to try our pate. So this is a very, I can't explain to you how much this means for me.
So it's like an aged fine wine then.
Better.
So
we're gonna have Polish pate sandwich with healthy bread from the supermarket. Sorry.
Danger.
And tiny little tomatoes.
Polish pate. Sweet.
Are you ready?
Yes. Really looking forward to this.
Okay, you want to do the honors?
Oh.
course.
Oh, hold on. I get you on my... Where's my phone? Okay. Hold on. I have to take a picture of you. Hold on. Let me... And your bike in the background. Oh, this is so nice. With your hair. Hold on. I'll do the portrait.
Good. Action.
I'm ready.
All right. Oh. Pop the top.
Uh-huh. Smell it. Smells like chicken?
Yeah, it does. Smells like...
You have no idea. I love this stuff so much. It's the taste of childhood.
Honestly. Taste of childhood, yeah.
Polish childhood. Actually, childhood from the east of Poland. Okay.
You don't have it in west Poland?
We have plenty of brands, but this particular brand, it's only available in east of Poland. You cannot get, like, it's really hard to find. So this is like a treasure.
Okay, and you found this can where?
In Poland, when I went to apply for visa with USA. Okay, so normally we'd put a, you know, big slice of potato, big slice of tomato here, but because we have these tiny ones, have a bite and have this, and tell me what you think.
Okay, all right. A first bite of
Polish pate. No, you have to say pasztet białostocki. Pasztet. Białostocki.
Yeah, it's not happening.
Białostocki. Białostocki. Okay, never mind.
Okay.
Yes,
not
that
gonna
one.
Happen. All right, so here we go.
Okay, here we go. What do you think? And you have to tomato straight away, tomato. It's nice. It's all right? Tastes like chicken.
Yes, it does.
Tastes like chicken, and it doesn't taste like liver, right?
Correct.
So it's nice. It's nice spread.
Yes.
I'm glad
you
enjoyed
it. This is good.
This is premium stuff.
This is better than smoked oysters and Vienna sausages. Much better.
Oh, thank you. I'm pleased you enjoy it. Cool. Right, so this is my special moment, my very last pastet. I'm going to miss you so much. I was carrying it in my... 5 months. For 5 months. Okay. Ready?
Yep.
I'm so happy right now.
Brings back camping childhood memories. Good deal. Those are always good.
good for you, your family, and your country.
Homemade muffin that my mom made.
Oh.
So, and she bakes for some of the
thank you. That's so nice.
Restaurants here.
Oh, really? I got a muffin. That's perfect. Thank you so much.
Guys, how's the fire?
Hot.
So hot right now, right? It took
one architect
and one engineer to set that fire.
That's right.
And build that community, right?
And we built a community around it. Absolutely. Yeah.